We set up this clinic, the long COVID clinic, following the work that we did, particularly in the first phase of the acute COVID pandemic. We ran quite a busy unit here, we saw an awful lot of patients. And what we realized from a very early stage that as patients were well enough to go home, they clearly weren't recovering as quickly as we would have hoped and expected. And so we realized there was something important to discover here. And we realized follow-up of these patients was going to be important. The problem was COVID was a brand new disease on planet Earth. We didn't know anything about it. We were just learning about acute COVID. And so precisely what we were going to find in follow-up, we just didn't know. No one knew at the time. So we set up a clinic that included a very broad assessment of patients, some 6 weeks, sometimes 3 months further down the line. We included blood tests, full breathing tests, lung function tests, a review by a physician like myself, psychological review, physiotherapy review, everything really.
I'm one of the people who survived with the illness, but I had long-term complication of COVID-19 due to the infection.
So part of the clinic today, what I'm going to do is look at how you're coping psychologically. Mm-hmm. Since you've been unwell with COVID.
I can't sleep very well at night time.
Okay.
And my level of energy is really very low. And I can feel tired from a very minimal exertion. This is the issue.
Okay. So struggling to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Feeling quite tired.
Yes.
They're the main issues. What we'll do in this clinic is we'll give you a really good MOT and we'll have a look at all of those symptoms. So the breath test will help us to figure out what's going on with your lungs.
Mm-hmm.
What we have found, and the world has now found, is this entity that has become known as long COVID, a sort of syndrome, a constellation of symptoms, many of which seem to be very, very common with our patients. Fatigue in particular can be very profound, it's very disruptive to life, and understandably people are very worried about it. There's a lot of discussion and a lot of research trying to get to the bottom of this to understand what the phenomenon is. And I'll be frank with you, we don't have all of the answers yet. Okay, our first patient today is a 47-year-old man. He's PCR positive on the 15th of December, and he was admitted to the hospital between the 15th and the 20th. His acute symptoms included breathlessness, fever. People would love to have a treatment, a pill if you like, take the pill and then long COVID's gone. That pill doesn't exist, it certainly hasn't been invented. So what we try to do in this clinic is to break that vicious circle at the points where we can. That's why we have a psychologist who gives the psychological advice. That's why we have a physiotherapist who gives physical advice on graded improvements in exercise. They will also have a very long array of blood tests done. We're checking for anything that could conceivably have gone wrong. It's a wide array of tests. Our patients will also get complex lung function tests, so we've got a very good idea of how well the lungs are working. And in addition to that, the vast majority of people will also get a CT scan so that we can be pretty confident that there's no ongoing or permanent damage to the lungs from the COVID episode. Now, it's relatively early days because this is a lung condition, as the name suggests, but we are seeing progress based on these interventional strategies focused on psychology, focused on graded exercise, focused on improving sleep quality, and focused on getting a patient to believe that they can get better.
Really, I'm scared that I'm going to miss my own self.